Layla was beautiful and strong. She was kind. I remembered that Layla liked purple.
In an array of pinks and purples, hundreds turned out for a candlelight vigil to remember Layla Fowler, the 8-year-old girl stabbed to death in her Northern California home on Saturday. The motive for her killing is still a mystery.
It does not happen to a person you know, much less a child you know. And this cannot happen to a child in your very own class. She will be carried in my heart forever.
Layla's family stood front and center, arm in arm, as the vigil began, before moving to the stage so they could see all the people present to remember their little girl. The family also spoke for the first time.
I just want to thank the entire community and all of our family and friends for the overwhelming amount of support that you've given my family. It will never be forgotten.
I'm not saying goodbye to Layla. I'm gonna see you later. There's no goodbyes. And I want Alan, please take care of my sister.
Madison was friends with Layla for 3 years.
She was very kind to everybody. She helped everybody. She made everybody feel good.
Her mother says she's having a hard time understanding that her friend is gone.
Madison thinks that she's going to be here the next day. You know, she's going to be here. You know, me and Layla, we have a play date on Friday. And it's like, you know, baby, I don't know what to say.
Kalia used to live across the street from Layla. She sobbed uncontrollably during the vigil.
She would always sleep over at my house. She said she would sleep over for one day, and she would sleep over for like a week.
Her and my daughter became friends, and Layla spent every summer with us since then. We were just talking about spending this summer together and what we were going to do. Our summers have changed forever.
Stephanie Elam, CNN, Valley Springs, California.
This is so hard for